Hello dear students, welcome back to Physics Online Crash Course class. So today we will solve some numericals related to expansion of the solid. So whatever the synopsis already we discussed, related to those synopsis, let me solve some numericals related to expansion of solid. Let me read out the question. An aluminium rod of length 50 centimeter. Well, aluminium rod is there. Its length is 50 centimeter. Is heated so that temperature is increased from 20 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius. That rise in temperature, 80 degree minus of 20 degree. So rise in temperature is 60 degrees Celsius. If linear coefficient of expansion of aluminium is 24 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Coefficient of linear expansion means alpha. 24 into 10 to the power of minus 6 per degree Celsius. Find that increase in length of the aluminium rod. It means that delta of L, right? Delta of L, which is equal to L into alpha into delta of T, right? So L value is 50 centimeter or 5 into 10 to the power of 1 centimeter. Alpha value is 24 into 10 to the power of minus 6 and delta of T value 60, right? Delta of L, which is equal to 24 into 5, so that is 120 into 6 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Delta of L, which is equal to, so 12 into 6, 72, or this is 720 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter, or delta of L, which is equal to 7.20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 centimeter. This is the required answer for increase in length. Next, we'll go for next question. Find the increase in temperature of the aluminium rod if its length is to be increased by 1%. Look at here, they given increase in length is 1%. Increase in length is 1% means delta of L divided by L into 100. This equals to 1%. Then alpha value is 25 into 10 to the power of minus 6 per degree Celsius. Which thing I need to find out here? Find the increase in temperature. Delta of T value. What is the connecting formula here? Delta of L divided by L into 100, which is equal to alpha into delta of T into 100. So this is 1% and delta of T. So alpha means 25 into 10 to the power of minus 6. 100 means 10 to the power of 2, right? 10 to the power of minus 4. If it goes to numerator, 10 to the power of 4 divided by 25. Which is equal to delta of T. 10 to the power of 4 means 10,000. So that is delta of T value. Sorry, 100. This is 400. Delta of T, which is equal to 400 degree Celsius. What is that rise in? Okay, next one. An iron rod of length 50 centimeter is joined at an end to copper rod of length 100 centimeter. They given different material here. One is iron. Length of iron rod is 50 centimeter and length of copper rod is 100 centimeter, right? These two rods are getting connected one by one. So one by one. 100 centimeter at 20 degrees Celsius. So at 20 degrees Celsius, find the length of the system at 100 degrees Celsius and average coefficient of linear expansion of the system. Average coefficient of linear expansion of the system. One is iron, another one is copper. So copper having different kind of linear expansion and iron is also having different kind of linear expansion. If these two materials are joined together, iron and copper, iron having length 50 centimeter, whereas copper having the length 100 centimeter, right? And they given that alpha of iron material, or Fe we can consider, that is 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6 per degree Celsius, and coefficient of linear expansion of the copper is 17 into 10 to the power of minus 6 per degree Celsius, right? I want to find out that average coefficient of linear expansion, right? So in case of this one, so total length of the combination, which is equal to, or change in length of the combination, or other sense I can write that change in length or increase in length, in change in length of the combination, which is equal to increase in length or change in length, increase in length of iron plus of increase in length of copper, right? Delta of L, which is equal to delta of L of iron plus of delta of L of copper, we can consider. So change in length of the combination, so delta of L, which is equal to what? L into alpha into delta T. So delta of L is a combination, so L means length of iron plus length of copper, total length, alpha of average into delta T, which is equal to change in length of iron, delta of L, which is equal to what? L alpha into delta T plus L alpha into delta T. Delta T terms will get cancelled out. So length of iron plus length of copper into alpha average, which is equal to length of iron into coefficient of linear expansion of iron plus length of copper into coefficient of linear expansion of the copper, alpha average. Finally, we will get the formula: length of iron, alpha of iron, plus length of copper, alpha of copper, divided by length of iron plus length of copper, we shall consider. Okay, now fill the value. Alpha average, so L of I stands for 50, this is 12, right? Next, alpha of C, so L of C is 100 into 17, 10 to the power of minus 6, I will take out common here, so 50 plus of 100, that is 150. Alpha average, which is equal to 12 into 50, so that is 600, right? 1700 into 10 to the power of minus 6 divided by 150, alpha of average, so 1700 plus of 600, that is 2300 into 10 to the power of minus 6, 150, 180, 80 means 15 into 5, 75. So you will get something, alpha average value is 15 into 10 to the power of minus 6 per degree Celsius. This is the required answer. Next question: a bar with a crack at its center, one metallic bar is there, so at its center there exists a certain kind of crack. A bar with crack at its center buckles as a result temperature rises of 32 degrees Celsius. As a result of increase in temperature, so that center part will getting rise by a certain distance, by a temperature of 32 degrees Celsius. If fixed distance is L naught, so they given that L naught value 3.77 meter and coefficient of linear expansion of the bar is 25 into 10 to the power of minus 6 per degree Celsius, find the rise in X from the center. So look at here, the given one metallic rod, right? So wait a minute, between these two rigid supporter, one metallic rod is there. So its length is L naught. Due to that rise in temperature, there exists a crack at its center. Right? Right. So original distance is L naught. So there exists a crack and this metal is getting rise by a distance x here. I want to find this value of x. They given L naught value. Let me write that L naught value and alpha value is 25 into 10 to the power of minus 6 per degree Celsius. What about that L naught value? That is 3.77 meter. 3.77 meter. I want to find the value of x here, right? Total distance is L naught. So half of the distance, small L naught, I will consider here, right? So this small L naught, which is equal to capital L naught by 2, right? Hope you get my point. I want to find the value of x here. This distance is L naught. Let me take this is small l, right? From the Pythagoras, x which is equal to, I will take that x square which is equal to L square minus of L naught square, right? So from that linear expansion concept, L square change in length. So L square which is equal to final length which is equal to L naught square, or L which is equal to L naught into 1 plus alpha into delta of t. This is the equation for final length, right? Now I will fill this value in equation 1. Wherever L is there, x square which is equal to, wherever L is there, L naught, L square is there, L naught square, 1 plus of, so here square. So if it comes here, 2 times of binomial expansion, 2 times of alpha into delta of t minus of L naught square, x square which is equal to L naught square, will make multiplication, 2 times of alpha into delta into L naught square minus L naught square. These two terms will get cancel out. So x square which is equal to this one, or x which is equal to L naught square is there, L naught under root 2 times of alpha into delta t. This is the formula, right? X which is equal to L naught value means capital L naught by 2. So that value is 3.77 divided by 2, right? 2 times of alpha value is how much? 25 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Delta of t value they given as 32 degree Celsius, right? 32 degree Celsius. So 3.77 divided by 2. So square root of 25 means 5 here, and 32 into 8. So that is 64. Square root of 64 means 8. So shall I take this one is 5 into 8. So 10 to the power of minus 6 means that is 10 to the power of minus 3 under root. So 40 or 4 we can consider. 20, right? So 20 into nearly 4, 80. You will get that answer 80 meter nearly. You will get that answer 80 meter, 3.77. Roughly I take it as 4 here. You will get that how much distance it will rise from the center. Nearly it will get rise at a distance of 80 meter from the center. From the center it will get rise by a distance of 80 meter. So we'll discuss some more applications related to expansion of the solid, right? So in case of that expansions of the solid, we are having certain kind of applications. In that application, the most important thing is bimetallic strips. strip, right? So in case of that bimetallic strips, that bimetallic strips having lot of applications. For example, in case of automatic on and off purpose, in case of iron box or in case of refrigerator. So in case of electronic devices, for automatic purpose we are going to use bimetallic strips. In case of that bimetallic strips, they will consider two different materials, and these two different materials are rivet each other. For example, one is steel, another one is brass. The working principle of this bimetallic strip is, it works on the principle of expansion is different for a different material, steel and brass. So these two metals will not expand in a same manner. Expansion is different for steel as well as brass here. For example, on heating, brass material will get expand more compared to steel. On heating, brass expand more than the steel. More than the steel we can consider. So brass material will get expand more than the steel. So steel material, steel bends with brass. Look at here. So whatever the steel is there, that steel material is getting bend with the brass on outward. Look at here. Initially I consider one bar here. So on heating, brass expand more, I said brass is expand more than the steel. So steel get bend with the brass in outward direction we can consider. For example, after heating, So straight bar is getting bent here. This is steel, I can consider. This one is brass metal here. So at high temperature, steel is getting brass in, steel is getting bent in a outward direction. So look at here, if it is a circle, means it is bending in a outward direction. For example, on cooling, so this is about on heating, right? On cooling, brass material contract more than the steel. Look at here. By cooling, which metal is getting contract first? Brass metal is getting contract first. So again, steel bends with rod. Steel bends with brass in inward direction. So on heating, it is outward direction. On cooling, it is inward direction, right? This is steel, this is brass we can consider. So this is at high temperature, right? So it is at high temperature and it is at low temperature. Two different materials are fixed one over the other here. So look at here, in case of bimetallic strip, I will place the two different materials one over the another, right? So initially it is in linear form. after providing certain kind of heat. So this metal is getting bent at a certain extent. Now I want to find out that radius of curvature of that bimetallic strip here. So look at here. I will take two different materials. I will place one over the other here. Then if I provide certain kind of temperature, because of that different expansion of the material, so these two material becomes curve here. I want to find out that radius of curvature. Let me take different materials are placed one over the other. I will take metal A and this one is metal B. Let D be the thickness of those metal. D we can take it as thickness of those metal, right? So after providing the temperature, it becomes a curve form. Curve structure I will draw here. Right, this is for metal A and this is for metal B here. Look at here, this is for metal A and this is for metal B. R1 is the radius of curvature of metal A and R2 be the radius of curvature of the metal B. So after simplifying, you will get that R, which is equal to D divided by alpha of 1 minus of alpha of 2 into delta of T, radius of curvature of the metallic strip. Remember this formula, where D represents that thickness of each metal strip. Thickness of each metal strip, right? Alpha indicates that alpha 1 and alpha 2 represents that coefficient of linear expansion of metal A and B. Coefficient of linear expansion of metal A and B. Delta T represents that rise in temperature or change in temperature we can consider. So hope you get this thing. Look at here. So I will consider one bimetallic strip here. After changing the temperature, so it forms a curve here. So if it is in the form of curve, means I want to find out that radius of curvature of this system here, or radius of curvature of the bimetallic strip, I want to find out by this formula. So hope you are understanding this thing. We'll go for next one. For example, in case of that pendulum clock, we are going to consider pendulum. So in case of that pendulum is getting expand or contract in case of summer season and in case of winter season. So if it will get expand and contract, means there exists a change in the time, right? Now let me find out that change in the time interval, or we can consider that effect of heat or effect of expansion, effect of heat in case of time period of oscillation of simple pendulum, right? So T, which is equal to 2 pi into square root of L by G. Time period is directly proportional to square of the length of the pendulum bob. So if this pendulum bob is getting expand, so if the pendulum rod is getting expand, means there exists a change in the time interval. So T dash minus of T divided by T, which is equal to half of alpha into delta T. After deriving that equation, you will get that change in time interval. So T dash minus of T divided by T, which is equal to half of alpha into delta of T. Now, because of that expansion, there exists a delay in the time. Because of the contract, there exists a more time. So now I want to find out that loss or gain of time in pendulum rod due to expansion or contraction, right? So I can consider that loss or gain of time in case of pendulum due to expansion per day. Within a day, how much time is getting lost or gain, I have to find out. So for finding out this thing, half of alpha into delta of T. So 86400 seconds. So this is the required formula to find out that loss or gain of time in case of the pendulum bob due to expansion per day. So within a day, how much time is getting lost or gain, I have to find out by connecting this formula. So hope you get this thing. And one more form we can consider: effect of moment of inertia due to expansion. Effect of moment of inertia due to expansion. So directly how to remember the formula. So moment of inertia, we are having the formula. So from system of particle I, which is equal to m into r square or m into k square, where k stands for radius of gyration. For constant mass, moment of inertia is proportional to square of the radius of gyration. I can rewrite it as delta of I divided by I, which is equal to 2 times of delta of k divided by k, right? From the expansion concept, radius of gyration means, that is, radius means distance from the axis of rotation to the edge point. Delta of k, which is equal to k into alpha into delta t. As I know that delta of l, which is equal to l into alpha into delta t. In the similar manner, delta of k, which is equal to k into alpha into delta t. I will name this as equation 2. Wherever delta k is there, delta of I divided by I. 2 times of delta of k means k into alpha into delta of t divided by k. K term will get cancelled out. Delta of I divided by I, which is equal to 2 times of alpha into delta of t. Delta of I, which is equal to 2 times of I into alpha into delta of t. This is the required expression for effect of moment of inertia due to expansion. So there is a connection between system of particle and thermal expansion concept. They merge two concepts, so we are having that.